Laudator Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome once again to this live broadcast coming to you from St. Peter's Square of the Recitation of the Angelus, to be led here, of course, by Pope Francis. Today on August 15th, the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. From wherever you're joining us, a warm welcome to you all. A special welcome to those broadcasters who link up with us. They include Catholic Television, the Catholic Faith Network, Salt and Light Television, EWTN Television, Radio Maria England, Atmar Darshan Television India, and Luminous Radio in India. And of course, a warm welcome to those of you joining us via our Facebook live feed and our YouTube live feed, and also via our website here, vaticannews.va. In just a few moments, Pope Francis will be appearing from that window there of the Apostolic Palace overlooking the square for this traditional appointment, always on August 15th, when he prays the Angelus with those gathered in St. Peter's Square. You can see there right now. The weather here, of course, it's a warm, sunny summer day, not too hot as in previous weeks. So thankfully, the extreme heat is not a problem here today, and the sun is shining brightly. This time of year, of course, is a time of vacation in many parts of Europe and North America, especially where it is summer. And so we have many visitors coming to Rome at this time, with August 15th being a special holiday around the continent. Yesterday, Pope Francis led the recitation of the Angelus and offered his reflections, as he traditionally does, looking at the Gospel reading for Sunday yesterday. And at that, he said that the Gospel provokes change in us and invites us to conversion. And he invited everyone to keep that in mind and to reflect a bit on that. Jesus brought the Gospel, the good news of God's love for each one of us, the Pope explained, and that's why the Lord says the Gospel is like a fire, because it's a message that, when it erupts into history, overturns the old ways of life, helping us overcome selfishness and break our dependence on sin, leading to a new life in Christ. Pope Francis also today will be offering his reflections, catechesis here, before leading the recitation of the Angelus. Following that, he traditionally offers greetings to all those in the square and invites us to pray for different parts of the world, as he did yesterday, recalling Somalia in particular and the Horn of Africa, the countries surrounding Somalia, due to extreme drought conditions and a great risk of famine there. So he called us to keep them in our prayers, as well as for the international community to come to the aid of Somalia, also affected by problems with food distribution due to wars in the world that detract resources from saving people's lives from natural and humanitarian crises, the Pope explained yesterday following the Angelus. Here he's coming right now. For those our radio listeners, he's arriving at the window, and you can hear the applause below in the square.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno, buona festa.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno and happy feast day. Today, on this Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Gospel offers us the dialogue between her and her cousin Elizabeth. When Mary enters the house and greets Elizabeth, Elizabeth says, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb." These words, full of faith, joy, and wonder, have become part of the Hail Mary. Every time we say this prayer, so beautiful and familiar, we do as Elizabeth did. We greet Mary, We bless her because she brings Jesus to us. Mary accepts Elizabeth's blessing and replies by giving us the Magnificat.
Per noi, per tutta la storia, il Magnificat è un canto di lode,
which is of praise, which we can define as the song of hope. Is a hymn of praise and exaltation for the great things that the Lord has accomplished in her. But Mary goes further. She contemplates the work of God in the entire history of her people. She says, for example, that the Lord has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He's filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. As we listen to these words, we might ask ourselves, is the Virgin not exaggerating, perhaps, describing a world that does not exist? Indeed, what she says does not seem to correspond to reality. While she speaks, the powerful have not been brought down. The fearsome Herod, for example, is still firmly on his throne, and the poor and the hungry remain so, while the rich continue to prosper. So then, what is the meaning of Mary's canticle? What's the sense of it? She does not intend to chronicle the times. She's not a journalist. But to tell us something much more important, that God, through her, has inaugurated a historical turning point. He's definitively established a new order of things. She, small and humble, has been raised up. And we celebrate this today, brought to the glory of heaven, while the powerful of the world are destined to remain empty-handed. When we recall the parable of the rich man and the poor man Lazarus, who was left, and the rich man was left without anything. So, Our Lady, in other words, announces a radical change, an overturning of values. While she speaks with Elizabeth, carrying Jesus in her womb, she anticipates what her son will say when he proclaimed the blessed, the poor and humble, and warned the rich and those who base themselves on their own self-sufficiency. The Virgin then prophesies that it will not be power, success, and money that will prevail, but instead service, humility, and love. And looking at her in glory, we understand that the true power is service, that the real power is service, and that to reign means to love, and that this is the road to heaven. So, let's look at ourselves. We might wonder, will this prophetic reversal announced by Mary affect my life? Do I believe that to love is to reign, and to serve is power? That the purpose of my life is heaven, paradise? Or am I concerned only with things here, with worldly, material things? Again, as I observe world events, do I let myself be entrapped by pessimism? Or like the Virgin, am I able to discern the work of God who through gentleness and smallness achieves great things? Brothers and sisters, Mary today sings of hope and rekindles hope in us. She sings of hope and rekindles hope in us. In her, we see the destination of our journey. She's the first creature who, with her whole self, body and soul, victoriously crosses the finish line of heaven. She's shows us that heaven is within reach. That heaven is within reach if we too do not give in to sin. If we praise God in humility and serve others generously. We shouldn't give in to sin. But we might say, so you might say, Father, but I'm weak. But the Lord is always close to you and always merciful. The Lord is always close to us with compassion and tenderness. He's always close to us, God, and the way He works. She, our Mother Mary, takes us by the hand. She accompanies us to glory. She invites us to rejoice as we think of heaven. Let us bless Mary with our prayer, and let us ask her for a prophetic view capable of glimpsing heaven on earth.
Et concepit de Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Gentri.
Ut digni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam Tua, in questum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che Angelus Nuntiante, Christi Filii Tui, incarnazione coniovimus, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis Requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucet eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, I greet all you Romans and those pilgrims who are here from other countries, and those from parish groups, church groups joining us. And I greet the young people from the Diocese of Verona, and the young kids of the Immacolata from Italy. I wish you a blessed Feast of the Assumption. I also wish a blessed Solemnity of the Assumption to all those who are sick and all those who need our assistance. We should not forget them. In particular, I would like to thank all those who are taking care of those who need special assistance during these days. Thank you for all that you do and taking care of them.
Dedicato alla Madonna, esorto quanto anni la possibilità a visitare un santuario mariano.
And on this day, let's remember that it's a perfect time to visit a Marian shrine. And why not for you who are visiting here, Romans and pilgrims, go over to St. Mary Major. And there's also the statue of Mary, Queen of Peace, put there by Benedict XV. And may Mary give us peace in our world. And let's always pray for the people of Ukraine. And happy feast to all of you. Please remember to pray for me. And have a good lunch and arrivederci. And Pope Francis waving to the crowds below, calling us to remember Ukraine, of course, and encouraging us to go visit a Marian shrine, as today we mark the Solemnity the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And that brings us to the conclusion of our broadcast here. Thank you all for joining us. Wishing you a blessed day. And to invite you as well to join us next Wednesday. We'll be back with a live broadcast of the general audience here in the Vatican. And that concludes our time with you here today. My thanks, of course, to my colleagues and technicians who've made this broadcast possible, and all of you for being with us. If you'd like to have a full text of the Holy Father's words here, just go to vaticannews.va or to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter profiles as well. A blessed day to all of you. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.